Sorry for the delay. I was actually trying to do something for you guys. Let's see how it pans out. So we had the lecture today in the morning. I have recorded it and I will share the video later on with you. Okay, I did not realize that I have connected. Okay, so I think now you can hear me. Okay, so I was saying sorry for being late. I was actually trying to arrange something for you guys, similar to the lecture we had today. So I was trying to arrange something more in-depth for the software. Anyways, so for today's lecture, those who attended, thank you. Those who didn't or couldn't attend, I will share the video later on with you. So what we did yesterday, we were working on the examples related to finding out adjustment factors for a statewide counting program for the control count locations. So you have control count locations, you can find out the adjustment factors for each day of the week and each month of the year as well. In a statewide program, your area is very big. Okay, it's a very large area. So you will have number of control count locations. You will have multiple control count locations. Okay. Even for the same highway, for the same land use, you may have maybe 30, 40 control count locations. So in the entire area, you may have hundreds of control count locations. So for each location, you will have a set of adjustment factors. Today we will talk about, or we will start the discussion about how to group these locations together. So grouping the control count location means what? It means that the different factors which you have from each location can be merged or combined into a single value. Okay, so for example, you have three locations. On each location, you have a different factor, adjustment factor for Monday. And you have a different adjustment factor for Tuesday and Wednesday and so on. So you have seven factors for each day, and then you have 12 factors for each month as well. So it will be a very large set of values. Okay, and then you have it for hundreds of control count locations. So in the end, you will end up with a very big data set. And every time you have to apply these adjustment factors, I will show you later on how to apply them. Every time you have to apply these adjustment factors, you have to look through the whole data set itself, the whole data bank, and select one adjustment or some adjustment factor from them. If I can compress this data set into a smaller one, how? By combining the factors from different locations. So for example, you have three locations. For each location, you have a factor for Monday. So it will be better for me, instead of having these three factors separate one for each location, I can have one factor which can be applied to all these three locations. So if Monday can have one factor instead of three different factors for three different locations, it will be much better for me in terms of analysis and in terms of data management. Now, how can I combine these factors? I will combine these factors by taking their average. Okay, so instead of having three factors, I will take the average of the three and I will apply this average to all the three locations. Okay, now which factors can be combined? That is an important point. The which locations factors can be combined, can be taken as an average. So there are two things. First of all, these factors, these locations must be spatially contiguous. Spatially contiguous means they should be close to each other. Okay. So obviously you cannot combine a factor from Bahrain to Saudi Arabia. And then you say, okay, the factor is same for the entire Gulf region. No, they should be spatially contiguous. So in terms of space, they should be close to each other. And there is a numerical criteria as well. And that is the difference between the average of the factors and each value for which you have taken the average should be within plus minus 0.1. The numerical criteria is when you take the average of the factors, then the difference between the average and the individual value for which you have taken in the average should be within plus minus 0.1. Okay. So for example, if I have three values for Monday, I take their average, then the difference between this average and each of these three values should be plus minus within plus minus 0.1. If it is, then you accept it, then you accept the grouping, you can combine them into an average. If it is not, then you cannot accept the grouping. You will not combine them into a single value. They will remain three individual values. Okay. So let me show you an example for that. So you can see this example over here. We have four stations. For each station, the adjustment factor for each day of the week is calculated. Okay, so seven adjustment factors for each station are there. And then we are trying to find out if we can combine them. Okay, so you can see they have calculated the average for each day of the week. So these are the average values. Now we will apply the criteria. Now, since we are using these four stations, so we will assume that these four stations are already contiguous to each other. They are close to each other. Okay, this thing is already solved in the map. Obviously, we don't have the map, so we cannot say whether they're close or not. So we just believe that these four stations are close to each other. So we are just looking at the criteria of the average. Okay, the criteria, the numeric criteria. Okay, we are not looking at the actual spacing of these points. So for example, if you take the average of Monday, which is 1.01, if you take the difference of 1.01 with each value of Monday, it should be less than plus minus 0.1. So for example, 1.01 minus 1.05, that is difference is minus 0.04, no problem. 1.01 minus 1, the difference is 0.01. 1.01 minus 1.06, the difference is 0.05. 1.01 minus 0.92, the difference is 0.08. So in all the four values, the difference is less than 0.1. So the criteria is met for Monday. You come to Tuesday, again do the same thing. Take the difference of average with these values. Okay. So station 1, station 2, station 3, no problem. For station 4, when you take the difference with average, the value is 0.13. The difference is 0.13. Okay. So this is more than our criteria. So this value is marked. Okay, and then we'll check the remaining values as well, and then we'll come to a conclusion. Okay, because we have to check 7 days and four stations. So we'll complete the checking thoroughly, and then we'll come to the conclusion what we have to do. So for the time being, this value is marked. You can see this is made bold. So bold means this is out of the criteria. Okay, Wednesday, we take the difference, there will be no problem. Okay, you want to do it, go ahead. Otherwise, just believe me. Thursday, no problem. Friday, no problem. Saturday, 0.98, you take the difference with each of the values. If you take the difference with station 1, again, you will get 0.13 out of the criteria. So you can see it is marked. This value is marked. This value, no problem. This value, no problem. This value, take the difference, 1.21 minus 0.98, it will be 0.23. So this is very high from the criteria, right? Compared to the criteria, this is very high. So again, I will mark these values, okay? Come to Sunday, then can you check the values for Sunday and let me know does any station have a value out of the range? Tell me, is there any station which has a value out of the criteria? Take the difference of the value with the average. Is there any value which is giving you more than plus minus 0.1?
The 1.1.
Okay, it is not marked here, okay, for tricking us, but we can know the difference of ourselves. So for this one, the difference is 0.18, so it is more than the criteria. Now the rule is, so we have found in the complete table there were 28 values. We took the difference of these 28 values with the averages, and we found that four values are out of the criteria. Four values are giving the range out of the criteria, giving the difference out of the criteria. Now the rule is, if out of these 28 values, if even one value is out of the criteria, even if one value is out of the criteria, then you cannot merge the stations. Okay, you cannot merge the stations even if one value is out of the criteria. Okay, then why did I perform this whole table? I should have stopped when the first value was out of the criteria, right? No. If I cannot combine four stations, then the next best thing is to combine three stations. So I completed the analysis so that I know is there a possibility that I can combine three stations? I cannot combine four stations, but can I combine three stations? Okay, and if I can, then which three stations should I select? Okay, so now let us go for that. Let us go for that option that we will try to combine three stations. Now, which three stations should be tried for combination? Or in other words, which station should I leave out from the combination? Tell me, any idea? Out of these four stations, which station should be left out of the combination first? Tell me.
The highest difference.
The highest difference?
Between the average and the station.
You can do that, or you can do that as well. But that will become the second priority. The first priority will be what? So we have four values, right? Four values out of the range. And they belong to, these values belong to which stations? Sorry? These four values belong to which stations? Station. The four values which are out of the range, they belong to station 1 and 4, right? They belong to station 1 and 4. Out of these four values, station 4 has 3 out of the criteria. Station 4 has 3 values above the criteria. So the logical thing is station 4 has more values out of the criteria. Leave station 4 out. Okay, so this is, like I said, this is the first priority. Look at the number of values out of the criteria and see to which station most of them belong. And then you take that station out first. So out of the four values, three of them belong to station 4. You can see 0.89, 1.21 and 1.1. So I will take station 4 out and I will see if I can combine the remaining three stations. Okay, and this is the combination of the three stations. So again, now we have taken the average, and this time the average is only for three stations. Okay, now the average for Monday was fine. There was no problem in the earlier trial with the four stations. Average for Monday was fine, no problem. So again, Monday doesn't have any problem. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, again, these 3 days also didn't have any problem with their averages and the individual values. So again, they will remain unproblematic, non-problematic in the new combination as well. The problem was for Tuesday, Saturday and Sunday. On Tuesday and Sunday, the problem was with station 4. Station 4 is out. Okay, the problem was with station 4 on Tuesday and Sunday. Station 4 is out, so that means no problem for Tuesday and Sunday as well. No problem for Tuesday and Sunday as well. So the only problem can be for Saturday station 1. Because station 1 is still there and station 1 had a problem on Saturday. So let us check if we solved this problem. If we have solved this problem. So now the new average for the three stations is 0.9. And the value for station 1 is 0.85. So 0.9 minus 0.85 gives you 0.05. So this problem is solved. If you want to check other values, go ahead. 0.9 minus 0.94, 0.04, no problem. 0.9 minus 0.9, 0. Okay. So by taking out station 4, I can now combine the remaining three stations. So my conclusion will be that you cannot combine station 1, 2, 3 and 4, but you can combine station 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So this is the final conclusion here. Now, after calculating the adjustment factors, what is they use? Where do I use them? So they are used for calculating the average traffic, AADT, average annual daily traffic, for the coverage count locations. Now, remember, for the coverage count locations, I don't have the data for the entire year or even for each month as well. So you cannot know the average for the entire year or for any month or for any day of the week. I may have data for 1 or 2 days for the coverage location. So I will use that data and I will multiply with the adjustment factors of the day and the month in which the data was taken from a control count location, which is the closest and the most appropriate one. Okay. Now, for example, ADT is 24-hour count on ith day and the jth month. I is the day. So if you take the data on Monday, I will become Monday. And J is the month. So if you took the data in September, then J will become September. Okay. Then you multiply with the adjustment factor of Monday. Adjustment factor of the ith day. So if I was Monday, you will multiply with the adjustment factor of Monday. And then you multiply with the adjustment factor of the month. So if the month was September, then you will multiply with the adjustment factor of September. Okay. I'll show you an example later on. So after multiplying with the adjustment factors, you will get AADT for the coverage count location. Now these adjustment factors, like I said, should come from the closest and the most appropriate control point, a control count location. So closest obviously means in terms of distance, whichever is the closest. But let's say the closest one is on an arterial and your coverage count location is on a local street. So obviously you cannot use an adjustment factor as arterial, right? So that's why I said the most appropriate one as well. So you will, if your coverage count location is on a local street in a residential area, find out the closest control count location, which is on a local street in a residential area. And then you take the adjustment factor for that control count location. Okay. And then you multiply with the count which you have taken on the coverage count location, you will get AADT. Okay. Let me show you with an example. This is the data in the table for the adjustment factors, first two columns for the daily factors, the last four columns for the monthly factors. Closer to this, closer to the location on which these adjustment factors are taken, we took a count on Tuesday in July, okay, on a coverage location, and this count was found to be 1,000 vehicles. I want to find out AADT for this location on which this count is taken. I want AADT for the location in which these 1,000 vehicle count is taken on a Tuesday in July. So what I will do, I will take 1,000, multiply with the adjustment factor of Tuesday, because what was taken on Tuesday. So 1,000 multiply by 1.121, okay? And then I will multiply with the adjustment factor of July, which was because it was taken in July. So 1,000 into 1.121 and into 0.913, the adjustment factor of July. So how much will be the AADT? Tell me the AADT, 1,000 into 1.121 and 0.913, how much?
1023.
Okay. And it will be vehicles per day, AADT, daily traffic, right? Vehicles per day. Okay, now we have also learned about VMT. So VMT stands for what? VMT stands for what? Anyone? VMT. No one? Some of you answered this question in the discussion board as well. Although we did not cover VMT 365 up till now, but some of you already answered, which is very good. This is the thing which I wanted. I wanted you to go through the slides yourself as well. So very good. Well done. So now I need, what do we mean by VMT? VMT. Anyone? No one? Okay, I will ask in the exam again, right? VMT stands for vehicle miles traveled. Vehicle miles traveled, volume into the length of the highway. And the unit or the time period of VMT depends upon the time period of volume. Volume is taken for 1 day. You multiply with the length, you get VMT for 1 day, daily VMT. If you take the volume for the entire year, you can get annual VMT. Annual VMT. So annual VMT is calculated as per this equation, you take AADT, which is obviously average annual daily traffic, you multiply by L, which is length of the highway. So now you will get average daily VMT. AADT into L will give you average daily VMT. Okay, and then you multiply by 365 because you need annual. You need annual. So you multiply by 365 because we have 365 days in the year. So you get the VMT 365, the VMT for the entire year. Okay, so this is how you get the VMT for the entire year, because we use AADT because for each location in a statewide program, for each location we calculate AADT. So using AADT is more convenient for us to calculate VMT for the entire year. Now I'll do a example here. Ahmad, you need to speak up. I do not see the chat during the lecture. So if you want to give the answer, you need to speak up. Okay. So in this example, what is given? We have the traffic counts which are taken on 6 coverage locations. For each location I have the length, and I have the day and the month and the count which is taken on that day, the 24-hour count. Then for these 6 locations, they are use these adjustment factors. So either this is the same control count location, so these are the adjustment factor from one control count location, okay, and they are using it for all the 6 locations because they are close and similar, or maybe they were these values are averaged from different control count locations. They have already grouped them, and now they are using it for finding out the AADT for the 6 locations. Okay. In any case, they can be from a single point, or they can be from a group of control count location. These adjustment factors can be any of them. It's not our concern for the time being. The point here is we have to use these adjustment factors to find out the AADT and the VMT 365. For these 6 locations. Okay, so let us go ahead. I'll prepare a table here. So I need the station, the ADT, and the VMT 365. Okay, so the station, we have 6 stations. For each station, I will calculate ADT. And ADT means vehicles per day. Okay, so if you come to station 1, the count is 9120. It is taken on Wednesday. So I will take the adjustment factor of Wednesday, which is 1.108. Take the adjustment factor of March, because the count is taken in March. That is 1.1. And tell me what is the value here. How much is the value? AADT?
11115.
Okay. Second location, Tuesday, September. Tuesday 1.121, September
10162.
Okay. Location 3. Friday, August.
One four three seven seven.
Okay, next. Location 4, Sunday, May.
16366.
Okay.
One,
six,
two, 9. Okay, next. 13990.
13990. Okay, now for VMT, I will take this value, multiply by the length, and multiply by 365. So 11115, the length is 3, and 365. How much?
2 long number, Doctor.
Yeah, yeah. I was
1217925.
Okay.
Doctor?
Yeah.
I have a pavement test. Can I leave?
Okay, okay. Who is this? Kusai. Okay, fine.
Thank you, Doctor.
One zero zero one four six five one.
One three one one nine zero one three. 2747-8514. Okay.
Seven six four zero two five three.
Okay, now a couple of points. So VMT, I told you earlier as well, gives you the importance of the highway in terms of its use. So VMT is higher, that means the usage of the highway is increasing. Usage can increase if the volume is higher or if the length is higher, because more length means you are spending more time. So you can see the most important segment is segment 4, which has the highest VMT. It has the highest VMT because it has the highest length and it has more users as well. So obviously more users using it for longer time makes it more important. The least important one is segment 5. Now if you look at the length of segment 5 is higher than segment 6, but still it is segment 6 is more important, has higher VMT because of the volume. So it has a slightly lower length, but its volume is way higher than segment 5. So that's why it is more important than segment 5. If you look at the volume, segment 1 has less volume than segment 5. Okay, but still it is not the least important one. It is not the one with the lowest VMT because of its length. So although less people are using it, but they are using it for a way longer time as compared to segment 5. So because of the combined effect of length and users, segment 5 becomes the least important one and segment 4 becomes the most important one out of these 6. Okay, out of these 6. And one more, which is an advice which I will give you as students. Whenever you are writing long figures, long numbers, large numbers, write it with a comma separation so it is easier for you to detect any mistake with the digits. When you are writing long numbers, large numbers, sometimes you forget to put that digit. So putting commas in between helps you identify if there's any mistake. Okay, so all numbers are in millions, right? I can easily identify all numbers are in millions. If I missed a digit, then it will change the entire figure. Okay, so it is recommended that you write it in this form, okay, with comma separation. Okay, then I will just take a couple of more minutes. The next topic is specialized counting studies. Up till now, we have done counting studies for specific locations. Okay, for a highway segment, for network of the segment, network of the segments, or for intersections. Specialized counting studies, we are interested in, no, we are not interested in any particular location of the highway. We are interested in the entire area, the traffic entering and exiting the area. In the specialized counting studies, we are interested in the total traffic entering and exiting the area instead of the how many vehicles are coming on a particular location of the highway. Okay, so there are three types of specialized counting studies: origin destination, cordon counts, and screen line counts. Origin destination means the study in which you try to find out the area from which the trip originated or started and the area to which the trip was destined or ended. So in origin destination counts, you are trying to find out the start area of the trip and the end area of the trip, the starting point of the trip and the end point of the trip, not in terms of point, but in terms of from which area they are coming out. There are three ways in which you can do the special the origin destination counts: license plate, postcard, interview studies. Okay, again, some of you read the slides and answered this question on the discussion forum as well, which is very good. Well done again. So what do we mean by these methods? Interview studies. So you select few houses, a sample of houses from each area within your origin destination study. So you have multiple areas, right? Some of them. So that's why you are doing the origin destination study. So in each area, you will select some houses. You will prepare a questionnaire. You go to those houses and you ask them about the destination of their trips. The origin is their house and where, in which area their trips are ending. So this is what we do in interview studies. Simple. Select a sample of houses. Go to these houses. Ask them about their trips. Okay. You will ask each member of the household where do they go usually and what is their destination and the area. Then postcard studies. You prepare postcards. What are postcards? On one side of the card, you have the questions. On the other side of the card, you have the address at which the card should be returned. So what we will do, you will distribute these cards to the drivers on the highways, on the intersections, or wherever it is convenient. Okay, you distribute the cards on the intersection, the highways, or wherever it is convenient for you in all the areas where you are doing the origin destination count. So you give the cards and you come back, distribute the card and come back. The driver is supposed to fill the card. So on the card, he will ask what is your origin, what is your destination, and he is supposed to post the card on the address which you have provided on the card. So the address is already written on the back of the card. They will just go to the letterbox and they will just drop in their postcard in the letterbox, and the card will be returned to your address. Okay, so in the postcard, the origin destination is mentioned by the driver. This is another method of origin destination count. The last method is license plate studies. It is similar to the license plate study for travel time. So for example, you have these four areas. Okay, your region is divided into four areas and these lines are the roads by which you can transfer from one area to the other. The lines which you see in the network here, in the figure here, are the showing the roads by which you can go from one area to the other. So you put observers on each of the roads which are taking you from one area to the other. So these observers will record the license plate number and the area from which the car was exiting and the area in which the car was entering. Then they will come back. Then they will come back and then they will see, they will match the license plate numbers from all the observers. The first area from which the car was recorded as exiting will become the origin, and the last area in which the car was entering becomes the destination. Okay, so license plate studies, the observers are recording, the observers are put on the roads which are joining the areas, and each observer is recording the license plate number of the car which is passing them. They are recording the area from which the car is coming out, and they're recording the area from which in which the car is going in. Later on, they will match the license plate numbers and they will see which was the first area that the car exited and which is the last area in which the car entered. The exiting area becomes origin, the entering area becomes destination. Okay, so on Thursday, we'll continue the discussion about origin destination counts a bit more. If you have any questions, you can ask me. Okay, otherwise I will take your attendance.